macro here just jumped right on my keyboard. Good morning, buddy. Today's going to be a good day for development because the WoW servers are down for the 8.1 updates, so that makes my life kind of simple. So last time we were working here, we fixed these two abilities. We're going to keep going. We're going to fix Rune of Iron. I'm just going to keep that ability the same. So let's get started here. So we're looking at the Runesmith. And we're looking at Rune of Iron. So right now, Rune of Iron stacks up to 2 times. I think I'm going to get rid of that. I just want to make it 1. Well, no. You know what? Let's keep that the same. Let's keep it the same. It's fine. But let's get rid of the block chance. And we'll up the armor a little bit. Oops. 20 armor, 30 seconds, that looks good. So we need an effect, which is here, Rune of Iron. Oh, we need to fix the standard cast for the dwarf. That's still something we had to do. Get rid of that ability effect prefab. So this needs to pull from effect. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so that's good. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and adjust the effect itself. So we'll make that 1, and it's just 20 armor. Okay. Hey, look at that. Finally, 8.1. Okay, so the effect's been changed, the tooltip's been changed. Save this. We need to go ahead and fix that precast. So the precast is something the unit does when it's casting. It's really kind of a casting visual effect. So we'll open up our testing map here. Let's give ourselves a little bit more visual room. And we are looking for the dwarf runesmith. Let's see here. Recast. Oh, I see I've already been working on this. That's fine. Let's see here. Oh, did I not save that nice rune effect that I have? Recreate that wasn't too hard. And let's go ahead and get a runesmith in here so that we have a size reference. And then we can, let's see here, put that underneath him, center it, and we're going to raise that up to here. Zero. There we go. We want no shape. We want a mesh. That looks kind of funny like that. Particle effects. Let's see here. What was it? It was this one right here. go. And then we had to set a custom material. Is it this? Let's see, rune band right here. Okay. So there's our runes. We'll do a randomized start rotation. Okay, and we're going to fade this in and out. And then size over lifetime. This is going to give us really the motion that we want. Maybe just a little bit more than 1 second, and then we'll do 3 of these. Yeah, that looks good. Start size, let's fluctuate that between 2 and 3. We'll decrease that rate over time a little bit. Let's lower this, good. And let's make it a little bit bigger. Let's try just adjusting the, let's see, so 5 and 5, yeah, there we go. Okay, so I want this to be 3 and 4, and so I want it to be not as, not as tall. 2.5, 3, 2.8, yeah, that looks good. And then a little bit of rotation over time. Let's increase the upper size limit here. Oh, we're getting ovals, aren't we? So we'll just keep this a flat fluctuation between 3 and 4.5. And then if we want to make it not as tall, we can just scale it. And then the lifetime, let's fluctuate that between 1 and 1.5. And the color, we're going to fluctuate that between like a light orange, pale orange. So let's bring that upper scale down a little bit. Let's bring that frequency back up again a little bit. Maybe a little bit more. Lifetime. Closer. There we go, it looks okay. I feel like I had that better the first time, but who knows. So let's get our camera right on top of this. So we can see what it would look like from like a standard play height. Looks okay. Let's take our runesmith and rotate him. And then I don't want to see these pink weapons right now. They're just placeholders. And then let's unparent our particle system. We should make these a little bit taller. Okay, not bad. I That's a little bit bright, I think, so let's bring that brightness down a little bit. Give it a little bit of transparency. Okay, not bad. Now, I want to reuse these runes over here. So I've got some runes. Yeah, we can definitely reuse this. So let's put that right where our other system is, and then let's see what this is currently set to. This is a circle. So I want these to emit up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna increase this rate quite a bit. Gravity multiplier minus 0.01. Okay. And maybe instead of a shape circle, we do a sphere. Yeah, that looks better. And then we're gonna do 3D rotation between 0 and 360. I don't think we're gonna go 3D with this one. Just 0 to 360, that's gonna be fine. Let's bring that emission down a little bit. And bring that transparency down. And I think the gravity, we're gonna randomize that between this and this. And we're gonna add a little bit of rotation over lifetime. And we're going to randomize that between negative 20 and 20. Let's close this so we don't have that. It's a little bit cleaner. So it's definitely too many runes, I think, right now. So let's reduce the size of the sphere a little bit to maybe 0.8. Let's bring that sphere up. And let's bring that weight over time down to something more reasonable. Emit from shell, we don't need that option on. There we go, so that's a little bit more reasonable. Okay, that's not bad. If we increase the rotation here, how does that look? And then what about color over lifetime? What if we fade this in and out quite a bit? So here we're in, here we're out, back in, out, back in. So that way they're coming in and out. I think the size, we need to bring that closer together, so we'll do 0.7 to 1. Okay, that's not bad. Now I think we need, let's see here, what do we have over here? We have some blue beams and particles. They're okay. I like the beams. So let's move that over to where our other effect is. Now, I think what I'm going to do, let's see, the shape is, yeah, it's a circle. So let's put that down to the floor. And then let's increase that radius. From the edge. Maybe a little bit closer in. What about decreasing the lifetime? Kind of a weird effect. There we go. If we bring it down below the floor, now we're just getting these clean stripes. So let's bring that emission. Let's just set this to a constant. Oops, 1.5. And the gravity multiplier, we can half that. And then we can double the lifetime of it. Well, that's a bit much. 2 is going to be fine, I think. And then we'll bring that emission up. So that gives us kind of like a little bit of an aura effect there. Start size is varying quite a bit here, so let's just up that a little bit, make it a little bit thicker. Can we go thicker? We're getting the artifacts again, so let's bring that down a little bit. And then we'll increase that lifetime. Okay, it's not bad. I think we're going to go with like a yellow, orange, and a blue for the dwarves. I think that's going to be a good color scheme. So now we need some kind of aura effect. So let's see, what kind of materials do I have for that? Maybe we'll just double down on the rune idea, you know? So let's create another particle system, put it right here. And let's bring that down towards the floor. Speed 0. No shape. Renderer is going to be a mesh. And we're going to do a quad. Up a little bit, there we go. Let's go ahead and set our rune material. I think we're going to go with what if we go with this one? Ooh, that's a lot. Lifetime emission 1. Increase that size. It looks like it's quite a bit above the ground, doesn't it? I just realized I need to adjust my camera a little bit. There we go. Okay. So what if we make this it not loop, we give it pretty much infinite lifetime. So we'll just wait over time. No, we just want one right at the start. Okay, good. Let's give that some color. Disappear. Okay, we're back. All right, it was weird. Is it because I'm adjusting the size? Rotation over lifetime. It looks okay. Let's bring that opacity down. That's okay. I'm not feeling it though. Just go with the runes. adjust this before I... So I'm going to have this loop. So that way I can adjust the color and get it right. Alright, this is going to be more of... adjust this color as well. Make that a little bit. There we go. So we'll walk these two colors towards each other. That looks okay. Now what if we bring the size in? You can't really tell that they're runes at that size. Okay, what about... we just do a circle. Yeah, that's okay. See, that looks okay. You can actually tell what shape it is, and it's a hard geometric shape. Yeah, that might work. There we go, I like that. Okay, that's not bad. Just a thought here, what if we randomize the start rotation? No. No, it's too unclean. Yeah, we'll leave it up like that. Now this one, we're going to have this, we're not going to loop this, infinite lifetime, because the VFX system's going to handle this anyway, so. Not bad. I think I want to tweak these runes just a little bit. Let's make these just a little bit more narrow. And then 3.5, 4.5, 4. Now that's getting a little bit too big. 3.5. 4.2, make them just a little bit more narrow, and let's bump that up to 3.5, make it a little bit more lively. Okay, it's a little bit too narrow now. If I just make this a constant size, yeah, that looks a little bit cleaner. Now we can bring that frequency down a little bit. Okay, not bad. So the whole thing together. Oh, what happened? Now we've got all these blue lines. Did I move this? Oh, I scaled the whole thing. Ah, son of a bitch. Back. Alright, that looks about right. So I'm going to unparent these effects so I don't do that again. So let's bring this up to 3.5. What did we have it at? 4? Make it a little bit narrower. feel like we're missing maybe one more visual effect here. What could we add here? Oh, we could add like a glowing hammer above it. That would be cool. So let's see if we've got anything that we can use for that. I've got some ability icons. Textures. Ability icons. Skills. Let's just see here if I've got any good hammers. Or, let's see. Looking for anything with a good hammer. Got these sorted by color. I've only got hammers coming from like a side. I wanted one from like the front. Okay, everything I've got is something like this. Isn't there one that's like a hammer from the front, like a flat angle? Might have it under weapon icons, let's see. Textures, weapon icons, transparent. We're looking at clubs. Yeah, they're all from they're all from the side. See? Hammers. I think we're gonna have to draw our own here. No big deal. So we'll open up Photoshop and we'll do, 500 by 500 is gonna be fine. So I think what I want is something that looks like this. So let's copy that. We'll keep that off to the side. Kind of as a reference. So I'm only going to do half the hammer and then I'll flip it. So I'm just going to do this. I am not an artist. Let me just start by saying that. This is me hacking together things because that's what I do. And we really only need like a silhouette of this hammer. Let's move this up a little bit. And I know you're probably wondering like, what the hell is this, right? It will make sense. Okay, so that looks weird, right? So we split it right here at the half of the circle. You know what? Maybe that circle needs to come out further. So we'll do it. We'll do another one of those. Try that again. Maybe we'll do an oval. Maybe a little bit more oval. Fill that. Now let's split that. Layer via copy. Free transform, flip. Apply. If we move that over. Okay, it's a little bit wide at the top, so let's move that in a little bit. Layer via copy, free transform, flip. help if we had a little bit of that hilt sticking up above there. And then I think we can take this part right here and increase the size a little bit to make it a little bit taller. Oops. That doesn't look great, does it? So what I want is this to be a little bit bigger. And then we'll do our connecting piece. And then I'm going to do a selection here. Going to move that up to see. Okay. I think that's looking a little bit better. Free transform, flip horizontal. Oops, forgot to layer first. Layer via copy. Free transform, flip horizontal. And let's move that over. Move it in. Let's move these together. So it looks pretty good. I'm happy with that. Okay, let's go ahead and cut these corners just a little bit. Just so that it's not super clean. I will keep that one. It's fine. Okay, duplicate. Now we're gonna turn this to a particle effect. That's why there's really no texturing on this at all. Layer via copy, oops, I did that. Pre-transform, flip horizontal. I think this will be our final version here. It looks good to me. Yeah, and then I'm gonna go back to one of these runes that I had. Let's see, we're gonna take the one that looks like a V. Let's open that up in Photoshop. Copy, paste, and what we're actually going to do is we're going to select inverse, oops, oh, whoa, that's not what I meant to do. I just want to move this selection over. Let's go ahead and color overlay white so that it looks like a cutout. And then we're going to scale this down. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a rune right in the middle of our hammer. That looks about right. So that we get everything centered, let's go ahead and get rid of this hammer now. Select all, and we're going to center this dead center. And then the same thing with the other layer. Now that looks like it has kind of fucked up a little bit. So we're going to do this one manually. I think it's still a little bit. Not feeling the rune for some reason. Maybe what we should do is take a circle this. I want this to be really accurate. And then we're gonna center this. Yeah. I'm gonna color overlay. Yeah, that's looking better. Okay, now I don't want that to be totally filled. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate this layer, get rid of that color effect, and I'm gonna select it, free transform and scale that down, and then select, ooh, it kinda looks cool with the moon right there. And we're gonna move this, come on. I know you're not centered. Select everything. You really think you're centered? Come on, that's not centered. Oh, it's like off by one pixel, right? Okay, we'll bring that size down just a little bit. Come on. Select inverse, free transform. So we're gonna have this right above the dwarf when he's casting. I'm wondering if we should like shrink this. You know, like bring it in a little bit. Something like that. This is the kind of stuff I need to be better at, which is not worrying about this kind of thing. So we're gonna convert this to transparent now. So we're gonna select that circle and we're gonna cut that out of the hammer and then we're gonna place the circle in. So that's our hammer right there. We're gonna trim all the transparent pixels. Okay. And we're going to save this as custom dwarf hammer. Okay. Let's create a new particle system right underneath our other ones. And we are going to go to our custom, create material. Hammer, particles additive, put our hammer in there, alpha is transparency, good. Oh, I'm pretty sure this should be white, I think. So we'll color overlay white here and here. Yeah, that's fine. There we go. Speed 0, shape none. Renderer passing that material we just made. Of course, it's always going to be really bright because we didn't change this. And there's our hammer. And we can actually scale that a little bit to make it look right. Looks like we've got some extra pixels down here. I think that's a texture thing. Clamp, yeah, that fixes it. Now the hammer, let's go ahead and reset that scale for a second. Well, now it does kind of look right, a little bit taller. Maybe we should just make it taller here. Image, canvas size, pixels, height. Let's go to 300. And we're just going to lengthen that hilt. Do that a little bit more, but I think for now that's fine. Does that look longer? Save. Doesn't look that much longer, right? All right, let's move these up. I feel like that didn't load correctly. Adjusted there, and we need to fix this ball at the bottom here. I think we can do better down here. Let's go ahead and extend this. Come on. Just go out a little bit. It looks like it's about the same. Let's see how that looks. Oh, much better. Yeah, that hardness really adds something. Okay, it's almost cross-like. Okay, so let's increase that size a little bit. We want that to be really prominent. Looks like we can't see that circle from here. I'm going to give myself a black background layer for a second so I can see what I'm working on. I mean, it looks great, you know, from here, but if we can't see it from 30 feet in the air, kind of defeats the purpose. Okay, get rid of that. Okay. Well, we want to change this color anyway, so let's get that done right now. And I want the transparency to be a little bit lower. There we go, now we can see that circle. Now, why don't we do this? Color over lifetime. We'll fade that in and out, and then we'll give it... So now it's kind of blinking a little bit, but I'm thinking, what if we had it scale? You know, we give it a longer lifetime. Let it scale like that. It's kind of cool, right? We do kind of lose the fact that it's a hammer. Snoring in my lap. Why does it look so stuttery? It's strange. Alright, I'm not feeling the size over lifetime. Okay, so that looks good. We'll just have this fade in and out. Reduce the lifetime. Increase the rate over time. the rest of our effects. Maybe we can raise this up a little bit more and then bring that scale down a little bit. Alright, that's kind of interesting. I think maybe we can go a little bit more orangish with the hammer. Yeah, like that. Okay. And then I think what another thing we could do, since, you know, we are so far away from this hammer, I think we can increase the size of this gap here. Let's make this a little bit more dramatic. So I'll do this manually, and just by moving this, it should be the same in all four places. There we go. That's a little bit better. We can do better than that, though. Let's make it just a little bit more. It's funny when you have to design things for to be seen from a great height. Okay. Yeah, that's much better. And then, you know what? I don't like these runes going up. Let's go back. These are in a shape. They're in a... idea here. All right. Let's move these up to here. Let's get rid of the gravity. And, it's interesting how my hammer is like off center there. Is he really above the runesmith? Oh, okay. Interesting. Might have to adjust some of those then. Okay, we'll call these spinning runes. This one is the, I don't know what, it's probably not technically an octagon. Octagon runes, blue beams, that's fine. Okay. And we'll call this hammer runes. This a not billboard but mesh, and I'm going to make it a sphere. I'm going to get rid of our shape. We're going to give this a constant size, and we're going to bring that weight over time down. And let's see, where is our material for this? I want it to have basically no glow, and I'm going to increase the canvas size quite a bit to make it relatively much smaller on that sphere. And let's go ahead and save this as rune 5 or rune 2. Room too small. And then we'll go to our materials, room 2, duplicate, control D for anyone that's wondering. Room 2, small. And let's go ahead and grab that texture. Now, hammer. Hammer runes. We're gonna plug in that new. There we go. Now let's go ahead and start rotation. We're gonna do 3D rotation, so 0, 360. And then we're gonna do rotation over lifetime. We're gonna do random. 40 minus 40, 40, minus 40. We're gonna bring that emission up quite a bit. Maybe too much. I think near the top here, maybe we could do with some more blue. Is that too much blue? Maybe we'll bring up the opacity and then bring down the rate over time a little bit. So if we put all of it together, it looks like that. That's okay. It's okay. There's something weird about having that double circle. Maybe we just need a solid stream of runes coming up. Let's see, let's try that. So we're gonna go back to this being billboard. We're gonna put it down here. I'm gonna change our color back to like an orange. And we're gonna do speed 1, take off our 3D rotation, we're going to go back to doing a shape. We do want a sphere because we want a little bit of variation, so we'll take it here with a speed and we'll use gravity to pull it up, minus 0.01. 5, 3, 2, yeah. And then we'll vary the start size. 1 and 2. So let's see what that looks like when we put everything together. I think we can move that hammer up a little bit higher. We can increase the radius here. That's a bit too much. 0.25. We increase the size of these runes. 5.5. There we go. So we have the runes going up to the hammer. What if we did it backwards? What if we did the runes coming down from the hammer? So we'll move this up here and just change this to 0.2. Let's hide that shape. Ooh, I like that already. Okay, but gravity, it makes the speed non-constant, so why don't we do velocity? We're going down, so what, minus 1? Oh, that's not even right, nope. 1, minus 1. Oh, I like that. Let's bring that shape radius down a little bit more. So it's coming right out of the bottom of the hilt. I wonder what would happen if we randomized the start size for the hammer. 0.9, 1.1. That's actually kind of cool. That's more of like a pulsing effect. Come on, Octagon Runes. You're part of this too. There we go. I like that. Okay, let's make this into the actual dwarf precast. So the way that we have our precasts working now is that we use this smooth VFX manager script, and what it does is it fades particle systems in and out, it manages them, so that way if you interrupt a cast or if you if your unit dies or something like that, we don't have the particle systems just pop out of existence. They fade out smoothly the way it should be. So let's create an object underneath our runesmith, exactly centered to him. And we're going to call this dwarf precast new. We want all of these to be child objects. And the way that this works is every script has to have a smooth VFX script on it to be managed, and then, destroy after delay is a pretty standard component. I wrote it myself, but there's so many variations of that script. And you can see that it's automatically adding that because that's a required component. Have here an audio source. Did we have an audio source on the other one? On the original one? I feel like we probably did. Let's see here. We don't want prefabs. We want Runesmith Dwarf Precast. Yeah, there's no audio source, right? I mean, it's got a uniform audio controller, but there's no audio source here. Okay. So we're not missing that. Okay, what else? Smooth VFX manager. Okay. And we are going to plug in our five effects here. Identity. What else do we need? The uniform audio controller, that's just kind of something we put on everything just in case. So if I ever do end up adding audio to this, and then we'll just copy this. It might be used by some script. I'm not exactly 100%. That's our new dwarf precast right there. So if we look at all those effects, yeah, it looks good. And then to see what the animation would look like, we can do casting. So that's his casting loop right there. Okay, so let's turn that into a prefab. We're going to move the old precast out, turn this into a new precast, or the new prefab. this, this, and this. We're going to turn off our testing camera. We're going to go to our actual RuneSmith prefab. And how did we do that with the precast? Is it just on a per script basis? It is on a per script basis. Spawn visual effect on ability start. Yep, that's the one. And then we want, where are you? Smith, precast new. We want, let's see, this is Rune of Iron, so we do want the cast animation to trigger. Now, I know we want to apply this also to his other skill, Forge Father's Blessing, Dwarf Precast. There we go. Now, if we switch over to our game server scene, we're going to have to build the client so that we actually can see that on, you know, on the client side. I'm going to take a quick bath. Be right back. Alright, I'm back. Alright, so let's fire up that game server. Just gonna check something while we wait. Pretty sure the servers are still down, but just curious, you know? Come on. Alright, fine. Don't hop on my lap, whatever. Alright, so yeah, everything's still off, I figured. Down for a while. Alright, so we're launching the game client. And it's going to automatically connect. Oh man, I don't have Skype running. So with a pretty quick cast, oh, that's pretty cool. But it looks like we're seeing the hammer first. And we're not getting a chance to see the other visual effects. we're seeing the runes. We're seeing the runes coming down from the hammer. And we're seeing a little bit of that blue, but we're not getting our octagon at all. So let's see if we can just touch that up a little bit. We're going to go back to our precast. I'm just going to work on it here in the game server scene. So the spinning runes, they activate right away. The hammer is there right away. Now, I wonder, are we not seeing this because of a height thing? Is that what it is? Can we pre-warm that? Yeah, that's going to be good. Pre-warm that. So that way we'll see that faster. And let's do color over... Well, no, we're not... It's got a really long lifetime, so if we do color over lifetime, it'll take forever. We'll never see it. Let me try this on the testing map. I have a feeling maybe I got a height thing wrong. If the height is off, that blue octagon is going to be under the ground. So we've got it at zero there. Yeah, it looks like it should be visible. But I can tell from the height that this is probably not a good height. And if we move this up to like 0.1, still not that much. 0.15. And we'll bring the color up a little bit. Let's turn on our testing camera. Now, one of the problems that I'm going to have with this is, you know, the octagon, it doesn't fade in, so it will just appear. Yeah, we can't do infinite particle effects with the system as I've written it, which is annoying. Let's see here. Okay, so here's the tricky thing with this. Okay, I don't think we're going to do the rotation. I think we're going to do start lifetime of 1. We're going to get rid of this, and we're just going to have it rate over time. Color over lifetime, we have this fade in, fade out, loop this, so if we set it at 2, it's almost constant. Now, I wonder if we do start rotation randomization, what would that look like? Well, that's interesting. It's not awful. I wonder if we put the rotation over lifetime back in, how that would look. Actually, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. Come on, buddy. You don't know where you want to be. Do you want to be here? Do you want to be over there? That looks pretty good to me. I think we can bring the opacity down just a little bit. And then maybe we can bring the size up a little bit more. Yeah, I think it was fine. Okay, let's apply that. testing camera back off again and rebuild the client scene. It's unbelievable that the Coulteran humans and Zandalari trolls still don't have a fixed release date. God, what a messy, messy expansion. Switch over to our game server, launch that. And I think if those effects look good, then we'll probably move on to, finishing Rune of Iron. Earth Shield is a really cool visual ability that I just don't know mechanically how it's what it's supposed to do. All right, let's move these guys apart from each other so they're not all casting at the same time. Still not getting our octagon. That's weird. Right, I'm going to pause the game server. And we should take a look at this effect as it's happening. Let's see here. So octagon runes, I'm not seeing them there, or there, we're seeing them here. I think I can kind of see them if I change the camera angle. Oh, you can see them, see, it's the problem is that they're so damn close to the ground. I look fine over here, though, which is weird. Yeah. Let's see, which ones are these? Come on, I know we're seeing one of them. There we go. We're going to have to move that up to like 0.2 and then really bring the color forward. Yeah, okay. Let's make that last change. Alright, where's our prefab? Dwarf precast, octagon, 0.2. And let's really bring that brightness up. Hit apply. Build that one more time, and then we'll test to see if that visual effect is working. Mm. launch that game server again. And launch our client. Sorry if that was loud as hell. Oh, come on, really? Still no? Now we're seeing it a little bit. Maybe our lifetime's just too long. See, this is the usual play height right here. You can kind of see it. Oh, come on. All right, we'll bring that lifetime. Let's see. Let's take a look at this. So now we should be seeing it half second sooner than before. Boot up that game server. And our client. I saw something. Let's take another look here. Watch, it's gonna be super bright. No, it's okay. You can kind of see it. See what it looks like when we cancel one of these casts. So he's casting. Cancel it. Okay, not bad. I think the last change that I want to make is a change to the hammer runes. Lifetime is pretty long on these right now, so let's bring that down to half of what it was. And we need to get that all the way down to here. So these need to come down a little bit faster. So velocity over time minus 1.5. Increase the emission a little bit. Maybe minus 2, and then we can time even more. So that'll be faster. Maybe random between two constants. So we'll do minus 1.5, minus 2. So that some of them take a little bit longer. Yeah, that's fine with me. And then we'll increase the emission just a little bit more. I'm pretty happy with that. Okay. Not even going to test that little change. That should be fine. Let's go ahead and open up our scripts again. We need to open up... Where are you? That's the plugins folder. This. Scripts. Game server. Alright, so we need to enable... where is it? Rune of Iron. Here at the end. So we'll test that next. Okay, let's launch that. So let's try Rune of Iron here. Oh, something happened here. Unassigned reference. Ability effect prefab has not been assigned. What did I miss? Runesmith. Rune of Iron. Oh, the visual effect. Okay. Just need to plug that in. Rune of Iron effect. There we go. I feel like the cast range on that is pretty short. Let's bring that up just a little bit. And what is the cast time on that? We can make that a little bit longer. Standard cast. Rebuild the client just in case. Already noon. It's crazy. Oh, nice. They're opening up Raid Finder for the Legion raids. That'll be nice. Archmage Temeyar. Alright, let's test this again. Oh, I think I forgot to make a change. I think Rune of Iron still stacks up to 2 times. Let's see here. Rune of Iron, where are you? There you are. Yeah, can stack, max stacks, 1. Load up that client. assign reference ability effect prefab. What is... Am I using an old reference here? Yeah, that's what it is. Okay, we do need to fix that code a little bit. Okay, so this shouldn't be this. It should be combat system instance temporary object from us. Visual effect prefab. Use ability position. Returning identity. We can get rid of that. Okay, good. Boot up that game server. There we go. You guys are going to be busy casting. Okay. Well, Rune of Iron seems to be working. How much is 20 armor? He's got 45 base. 45 base is 31% damage reduction. And then with the buff on, so 39 versus 31. So it's 8% damage reduction on physical. It's nice. Maybe we'll bring that up just a little bit. Let's see here, Runesmith, Rune of Iron. Oh, we gotta fix this tooltip. Stacking up to 2x. For 30 seconds, and we'll bring this up to 30 armor. That's a bit much. 25 armor. And then we'll go to effects, Rune of Iron. 25 armor, okay. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and check Rune of Iron off. Earth Shield, what are we gonna do about you? Alright, we're just going to work on Rune Shield for now. Rune Shield is kind of an interesting visual. Well, you know what? I was going to make some adjustments to it, but... I don't think that's really worth the time right now. Rune Shield, we want this to be instant cast. Shield prefab, shield absorption. It looks good to me. The script looks fine. Let's take a look and see what it looks like inside. To change this script here, the quaternion to be quaternion.lookRotation, and we want it to be this right here. Okay, and that returns a game object. Let's go ahead and comment out this since we just fixed that or replaced it. Oh, interesting, interesting. So the reason we use the spawn temporary object is because it adds it to a collection of summoned objects by that unit, which are then destroyed when that unit is destroyed. We do want it to be destroyed when the unit is destroyed, but I mean, it could go either way, honestly. Is this a synchronized variable? No. But honestly, it's just server-side. It only matters server-side. So we should be fine like this. I think we can maybe clean this up a little bit. Projectile barrier. Let's do public void initialize, owner ID, shield value, and we'll just plug that stuff in. Up a little bit. Let's see. Unit.owner.id shield absorption. A little bit cleaner. And then let's go ahead and turn that ability on in the game server. Windsmith. Don't need the test rune of iron right now. So we'll turn back on the rune shield. Let that compile. Server. See if this works. There we go. Let's make sure it's still blocking projectiles correctly. Ooh, I might need to adjust that end visual effect there. It's not the best. Alright, so moving in range of these guys, put the shield up, and it is being blocked. see here, we're looking at testing map, and we're looking at rune shield shatter effect. Let's go ahead and turn on our testing camera. So the problem with these is that they have these hard edges. I think I probably did that on purpose at the time. So one of the things that could be improved, the shape is a sphere right now. We could make that a mesh, and then where is our actual rune shield? Because wouldn't it be better if we had the rune shield itself? Right? But then we have to worry about rotation and stuff. Ah, what the hell, let's see what it looks like. Rune shield. Okay. So there's our shield. No, it's getting too complicated. How can we make this less ugly? I think for a start, we can bring the transparency down a little bit. We can bring the size down. And the radius of that sphere. And, oh my god, 100 really? Let's try 75. Change this material here. So here's what this looks like. Oh my god. In Photoshop. Cat's looking at me funny. What if we had this be what if we just had that like really light, and then we took one of our runes. So we're going to make this rune white. just see what this looks like. One. So let's go here. I'm going to adjust our particle effect, shatter, duplicate that. Call this shatter rune one. Plug that in. Alpha is transparency. There we go. Shatter rune one. Let's hide this shape here. And I think because this is so transparent already, we can just increase that. It looks okay. I think we can make some changes here. So this rune, we need to go even bigger. Bigger, 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 bigger. There we go. Bring that down a little bit more. And this we can bring down a little bit more as well. There we go. Now that's more like runes breaking. Now, if we take this, let's go to rune one. Plug that in. Color overlay. Do white. Transform and really scale this up. Put that in there. Now we got 23% opacity there. We'll do 23 there, and we'll save this as an alternate copy. Call that rune 2. And let's go ahead and duplicate this, and we're going to plug in that other texture. Oh, did I leave a black on? I did. Alpha is transparency, turn that back on. I'm actually going to copy this effect, make it a child. We're going to bring this down to 30. And the other one to 30, so we'll split that in half visually between rune 1 and rune 2. So that's what that looks like. It's not bad. It's not bad. I think rune 2, we can increase the radius here, and then increase the speed. Here, we'll decrease the speed a little bit. Oops. Yeah, that's fine, that's fine. So that we have some runes that are going quickly. Bring that lifetime down a little bit, I think, from 0.6. Okay. Now, did we have some kind of effect when we instantiated? Now, let's see here. Runesmith. Rune shield. Does that have some kind of no, it doesn't. It doesn't. Okay, let's see. What do I got here? I want some kind of like explosion effect. Let's see. something, I'm looking through my animated effects here. Let's see, do I have anything here? Yeah, that kind of works. I like that actually, that's nice. So that's hit outer. Let's see which prefab is using that. Let's see, is it this one? No, but I still like those sparks. Yeah, those lines are nice. And then that glow's not bad. Even these particles are okay. Change the color a little bit. Flash is okay. I kinda like it. I don't like that, but I do like the other ones. Alright, let's see what that looks like. I think we can get rid of those particles. I feel like this whole thing is getting a little bit too big. So let's see here, particle effect. Let's bring that shape in. 0.3, 0.5. I'm gonna bring this shape in a little bit. There we go. 0.2, 0.4. It's much faster. Now let's have a surprise. Okay, not bad. I like those lines. Let's see if we can make those pop a little bit more. First of all, we want more of these. Bring that up. Increase the size. And we're emitting it from a very small sphere. How's that look? Yeah, it's much better. And then I can't even see the flash, it's so fast. These lines, we're going to randomize the speed here, 10 and 15. There we go. That's what I want. That looks great. Much better. Okay, let's see how that looks in game. I don't really want to spend a lot of time cleaning up visual stuff, but that was pretty ugly, right? That was pretty ugly. that game server. And the client. So let's see what this looks like when it shatters. So we'll get two of our runesmiths up here. Nice. Okay. One more. Oh, I love the way that looks. Okay. Yeah, much better. Much better. Okay. All right. So we're going to check off Rune Shield, that's done. It's 12:30. Let's see, I'm about 2 hours into this. I think I'm gonna take a little break and do some work around the house and get some meal prep done. And then I'm going to come back after lunch and do another one. All right, when we come back, we're going to do tectonic shift. And Stonebreaker, I guess. That one might take a while, but it's a good one. All right, we'll see you in a little bit.